things over the past few weeks. This is David Newman. He's from Pint and Jigger, and we're going to find out more about Pint and Jigger in just a moment. This week, all through Wednesday, we're going to highlight holiday sort of drink ideas. And David, what do you have for us this morning?
All right, so we took one of the most popular cocktails of all time, which is an apple martini.
Okay.
And we decided to kind of flip it on its ear. We took a lot of the same ingredients, but we decided instead of using a sugary syrupy liqueur, we're going to make fresh apples, cinnamon, vodka, and a little bit of the Devil's Cut bourbon.
Yeah.
And then we took a kitchen cooking technique called sous vide, and we sous vide this for the last 2 days, basically cooked it in water.
Wow.
At 120
I never thought
degrees.
About sous-viding something
that is
to make a
drink. That
is a
clever idea.
So delicious.
The best part about it is ready to go, so all we have to do is mix it up.
Okay.
So vodka, bourbon.
A little bit of lime juice, fresh apples, cinnamon stick, a little bit of simple syrup.
And you guys will be featuring this at Pint and Jigger?
This will be on feature for the next, through the end of the year.
Okay, and this is the final product, if I'm not mistaken.
So how do we go about...
So we can just go ahead and pour a decent amount in there. If we have a little extra, it's all right.
With the apple too, or...?
Oh, the apple can stay or go.
Yeah! Careful!
Sorry.
That's some for the homies.
Something and for the homies.
We're just going to go ahead and give this a good little stir. We'll also be featuring this on Wednesday. We're doing a big charity event.
Tell me about Wednesday.
Wednesday we're doing something called Island to Island. It's a charity event for the victims and people who need help recovering from Hurricane Sandy.
Okay. We like that. Love that.
So we got some real great beers donated. We have a silent auction,
wow,
a shuffleboard tournament, and should be a really good time.
Very cool. Starting at 4:30 on Wednesday.
Yeah, it'll be all night. Come down, check it out, support.
David, while Olena, if you don't mind, you want to
okay,
give it a
shot? Twist my arm.
There you go. Thanks,
and
David.
And you also have some
it.
Beer too.
So there's a lot of the craft beers that we're trying to feature, especially this time of year. They come out with their seasonal beers. This is a Wimmer Burr. It's a 7.2 alcohol by volume. It's got a nice little kick to it.
Uh-huh.
It's a red ale. Goes really well for this time of year.
Tell me what you
this
want folks
delicious.
To experience. First off, where you guys are, because you're really centrally and easily located.
We are on 1936 mm-hmm. South King Street.
Okay.
We're
right near McCully.
Right near McCully.
If you hit McCully, you've gone past a little bit.
Everybody knows where Jimbo's is. We're right next to
but
them.
If you go like at 6 o'clock, parking's free on street. I've noticed that.
Free on street.
See?
We also have parking on Young Street.
See?
1939 Young.
You're not talking. This is not my first rodeo at Pint and Jigger, my friend. What do you hope folks get when they go to the place? Because you guys have a number of different beers. I mean, if you're not, and Elena, let me get your...
It's fantastic.
Is it?
Yeah.
Thank you.
It's like apple cider with a little tinge of the bourbon and the cinnamon. It's delicious.
Very holiday.
What inspired you to create this? Like, how would you know that this would pair well with a Thanksgiving dinner?
You know, it's basically just a classic with a classic. You're taking the cinnamon and apple from an apple pie and then basically combining it with Thanksgiving dinner, which
mm-hmm.
would be perfect.
Turkey and stuffing. Mm-hmm. Mm.
What you hope folks get when they visit Pint and Jigger, because as we said, you guys have a number of different beers, but that's not all either.
No. We definitely want people to come down and experience the craft beers and the craft cocktails. The food, though, is the surprising part. It's absolutely phenomenal. So we want people to just have an experience at Pint and Jigger that's going to be...
Tell me what makes the cheeseburger so special, because I think it's probably one of the best cheeseburgers I've ever eaten.
Oh, thank you.
And I've had a lot of cheeseburgers. Look at this.
It's something that the chefs worked on a lot. We have a beer-infused cheese, and the burger is also marinated in Guinness. You combine that with their cooking technique, and it's just phenomenal.
Wow.
I think you had Taizo and I at Beer and
well, check out Pint and Jigger, island to island. I get it, from our island to the island of New York, benefiting the victims of Hurricane Sandy. Open from 4:30. What time do you close?
That night, we're going to stay up until 2, see how much money we can raise.
All right. And
perfect.
The money going to the American Red Cross. Thank you, David.
Thank you guys
thank
very
you,
much.
Pint and Jigger, check it out. You're open.
Seven days a week.
We
do an amazing Sunday brunch if you want to come down and watch football.
Sunday brunch.
Check it out.
And you'll have this knott apple martini through the holidays.
Knott
as
apple
a special.
Martini through New Year's.
Okay. All right. Thank you, David. We will wrap things up on Wake Up Today, let you know what we've got in store tomorrow. We will tell you. It revolves around another drink that we'll be creating
delicious.
As we welcome in the holiday season. Stay with us right here on Wake Up Today.